Well, there's really no controversy. Low-fat, calorie-restricted diets and exercise are the best ways to lose weight, reduce diabetes and heart disease, and live longer. It's all because calories in equals calories out. All we need to do to lose weight is eat less and move more, correct? Hold on just a minute. Are any of those statements actually true? I'm Steve Goldring from simplehormones.com. I help patients and healthcare practitioners with easy to understand patient education resources. If you know of a patient education book or resource that you'd like to have me review, drop a comment in the space below and I'll see if I can get to that as soon as I can. Be sure to like this video and hit the subscribe button to get notified anytime I post a new review. Population studies tend to support the idea of eat less, move more. But population studies are usually designed to ask people what they had for breakfast 2 years ago. People don't really remember those kinds of things as well as they think they do. In addition, people also answer diet-related questions in ways that try to make themselves look good rather than always answering truthfully. What we need is a well-designed, controlled trial to find out once and for all if a low-calorie, low-fat diet along with exercise can truly help people lose weight. Hold on just a minute, that's already been done. The Women's Health Initiative was a giant study conducted all over the world. It cost billions of dollars and enrolled over 50,000 women. When we talk about the Women's Health Initiative, usually what we're meaning is we're talking about the hormone arm, the part of the Women's Health Initiative that looked at the impact of hormone replacement therapy on women after menopause. But that's not what I want to talk about here. I want to look at a lesser known part of the WHI that's all about calories in, calories out, and whether a low-calorie, low-fat diet along with exercise can help people lose weight. It's that conventional wisdom, eat less, move more. The women were divided into two different groups. One group was asked to reduce their fat and calories, to increase the amount of carbohydrates they ate, and to exercise more. That group was given regular weight and diet classes and lots of personal coaching. Their goal was to decrease their fat intake to around 20% of their total energy, to increase fruits and vegetables, and increase grains. The second group of patients was given some simple dietary guidelines and pretty much nothing else. Over nearly 8 years, the group with the weight loss coaching was able to decrease their fat intake by a lot. In fact, their fat intake went from about 38.8% down to 28.8%. Not quite as much as their goal, but it was a substantial amount. They decreased their calorie intake from 1788 down to 1446, about a 19% drop. They had about an 18% increase in carbohydrates from 44.5% up to 52.7%. And their exercise increased by about 14%. Significant. They were eating 35% less fat, 19% less calories, and exercising a lot more. Did they lose weight? There was no significant difference between the two groups after one group had dieted for almost 8 years. But there was a difference between women who exercised and women who didn't. After about 3 years of a low-calorie, low-fat diet and exercise, the women in the exercise group had lost an average of 0.25 pounds apiece. Wow, that's so impressive. Eat less, move more had been clinically proven to be a complete failure. You can read the full text of the study for yourself if you'd like to. Here's the link and I'll post it in the description below. Well, there are all sorts of ways that the authors of the study tried to dress up the data, but the bottom line is that a low-fat, low-calorie diet, even with exercise, had zero impact on women in a controlled trial. If you're a patient whose doctor has told you to eat less, move more in order to lose weight, you may want to think about getting another doctor. Eat less, move more, and calories in, calories out, those are catchy little phrases, but they completely misunderstand the ways people gain and lose weight. They also completely miss the complexities of human metabolism. The medical establishment has harped on low calorie, low fat, eat less, move more for 40 years. And it's done nothing to decrease the weight in our society. In fact, obesity, diabetes, Heart disease and major chronic diseases have exploded in the last 40 years. Dietary guidelines, especially those released after about 1980, not to mention the same dietary guidelines that were given to the women in the Women's Health Initiative study, those may be partly to blame for this explosion of obesity, diabetes, and chronic disease. If you're a healthcare provider, be sure to read through some of the Women's Health Initiative studies, especially the ones on weight loss. Be sure to look at it with both a critical eye and an open mind. If you like this video, be sure to click the like and subscribe buttons to get notified next time I release a new review. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll talk again soon.